Hello and welcome to this Hangout on Air from Suntico. Today, we're addressing developers of business software who would like to connect their application to modern accounting software. And today, we're specifically talking about how you can connect your app easily to Sage 50 and specifically Sage 50 US edition. My name is Hugh Johnson. I'm head of business development at Suntico. And if you enjoy today's Hangout on Air, please do get in touch with me or share this Hangout with your friends and followers via your social networks. If you have any questions, of course, you can contact me via the normal social channels or by email at hugh.johnson@suntico.com. Today, we will talk about five things. We'll talk about why would you want to connect your app to Sage 50 accounting software. We'll discuss briefly the challenges that you may face if you actually want to do that. I'll then go on to introduce what Suntico is, and specifically what Suntico is for an app developer like yourselves. And I will discuss the business model that we're making available to you and how you can get started. So firstly, why would you want to connect your app to Sage 50 accounting software? The answer is very simple. It's to massively increase the market opportunity that you face, because I would maintain that actually by addressing the Sage 50 US accounting software market, you're actually increasing your market opportunity by 100 times compared with QuickBooks Online. Now that might sound odd because there are more QuickBooks Online customers out there than there are Sage 50 accounting customers out there. But if you do the math, it's actually very straightforward. Because although QuickBooks Online probably has maybe around about 2.5 times more customers in the United States than Sage 50 accounting does, those companies are much smaller. And in fact, I would maintain that the average Sage 50 accounting customer is probably about 10 times the size of your average QuickBooks Online customer, with 10 times the number of transactions. And then if you take the 10 times number of transactions, and then if you look at your number of developers, your competition, probably for every app that is out there in a particular category, if you're out there competing against other developers, there's probably 25 other developers that you're competing against in the QuickBooks online market compared with Sage 50 accounting. So for every one of you competing in the Sage 50 accounting space, there's probably about 25 developers competing in the same space within QuickBooks Online. So although there may be 2.5 times as many QuickBooks Online customers, you've got 25 times the competition. So if you do the math there, it actually works out at a market opportunity 100 times the size for you, the developer, compared with QuickBooks Online. And actually, if you take that to look at Xero, another online accounting package, we can take that 100 times to 1,000 times, because there'll be 4 times as many Sage 50 accounting customers in the United States as there would be Xero customers. So there's actually a bigger, much, much bigger, not marginally bigger, a much bigger market opportunity for you as a developer if you can tap into those existing on-premises accounting software companies, or those companies that are using existing on-premises accounting software that's out there. So why isn't everybody doing this? Well, the answer is simple. There are big challenges connecting your cloud app or your mobile app or even your desktop app to packages like Sage 50 accounting. And we as a developer have been through that experience ourselves. And I don't think this is particularly unique to Sage 50 accounting. These are the challenges that you face if you're trying to connect your app to another on-premises piece of accounting software. The first and most obvious challenge is that your clients install their software locally, by and large, which means that somehow you have to install a piece of software locally on their machines, on their services, on their servers, for every single client you have, if you want to deliver your app to that customer. Now, that in itself is a major challenge, because every single customer will have a different configuration, or there'll be multiple variations on the theme, whether it's variations in operating system release level, different client server configurations, different security and access rights configurations. And these are all things that we, as a developer, have come up against. And these are the things, the subtle things, that make it challenging to deliver in scale a piece of software to a large market of on-premises accounting software users. And then you have the third item there, which I've called updates and upgrades. So you've got your base of 100, 500, or 1,000 clients, imagine, using your app, using Sage 50 accounting. And then all of a sudden, Sage publishes an update to Sage 50 accounting. And maybe 30, 100, 200 of your clients just upgrade immediately. There's a very high chance that your app will stop working. And putting various clauses into your agreement with your client to say that they must not upgrade or update without consulting you is not going to get you anywhere. And it's actually a major challenge. And I've spoken to many developers out there, and just in terms of maintaining the compatibility of their app with the on-premises accounting software. And it is a major challenge. But it's a big prize. As I say, the market opportunity, maybe 100 times the market opportunity as a developer when compared with, say, QuickBooks Online. So if we're talking about those challenges, I want to talk now about Suntico and how Suntico can help you address and overcome those challenges and address that very large market opportunity that's there. So firstly, what is Suntico? Well, Suntico is actually all about the data. It's all about helping customers who use Sage 50 accounting software and other popular on-premises accounting software products to get the best out of the data that they have on their servers within their accounting software. And what Suntico is a cloud platform that connects people, apps, and data together. And so we look after a local install of a connector service which runs locally against the Sage 50 accounting software and synchronizes that data up into a cloud database where it can be accessed and used by other people, other apps, and other services. And if I look at that conceptually, what we have here is a slightly more complicated diagram, but we've divided the picture into two halves. We've got the cloud half at the top, and we've got the on-premises half at the bottom. And you see at the bottom, we have Sage and Intuit and other on-premises accounting software. Today, we're working with Sage, Intuit are on the roadmap. And what happens is the client installs a local piece. A local piece of connector software called a connector client, which sits there and pulls Sage for updates and updates Sage in return. And that information is published up into a cloud database of accounting data, which can then be accessed by other apps and services via a web API that we publish, which is available to ourselves and to developers. Now, what Suntico also provides is an online CRM account management app. So there's our own app there. Our own app interfaces to the Sage data through our own web API, the same API that you as a developer would use. We're also, through our own investment, creating other integrations, for example, to Microsoft Power BI and to MailChimp. But we're making this API publicly available to you as a developer so that you can integrate your app also to the Sage 50 accounting data. Now, as I hinted at before, we're not just talking about Sage 50 US edition. We're in fact talking about all three variations of Sage 50 plus QuickBooks desktop edition Sage 100 and Sage 300. We're not particularly interested at the moment in connecting to QuickBooks Online because typically the size of company using QuickBooks Online tends to be very small and doesn't tend to be a very interesting market for, I believe, for developers of applications that use the transactional accounting data. Now, the business model that we're presenting to you as a developer, I think, is very attractive. Firstly, it's free. It's free for you as the developer. And the model is that the customer pays for the connection. In other words, the customer pays for the integration. They pay us, Suntico. We look after the installation of the connector service, and we look after that connection. And if the customer has a difficulty or a problem with that connection, then they turn to us, and we will resolve the problem. Now, when it comes to accessing your app, we offer two models to developers. The simplest model, perhaps, is the customer pays you directly and just takes out a subscription to you directly. Or if you want to make your app available for purchase via the Suntico platform, then we can also do that, and in which case we'll be looking at a revenue share between ourselves and yourselves for the subscription of the customer to your app. So it's actually a very simple business model. So if you're interested in growing your market opportunity for your business app by perhaps 100-fold or more, then why not take a closer look at us? And we're currently just about to enter beta test stage with a handful of developers, and we'd certainly welcome if you want to register for participation in that. Just go to www.suntico.com/Sage50API, and there you will find the registration page where you can register your details, and we will be in touch with you when the beta opens. If you want to see and experience the kind of data that is available through the API, then on the same page at the top right-hand corner, you see Try Our Demo, and you can register to try our demo account of our online account management app. And there you can actually see firsthand the Sage data that will be available to you as a developer should you join our developer program. Thank you very much for your attention, and I hope you can enjoy our future Hangouts on Air.